Hello, my sweet apples, and welcome back to another vlog. So today is gonna be more of like a sit-down video. I promised you guys a planning video, and I am here to deliver. I'm not gonna be actually planning any lessons today, but I wanted to share with you guys some of the things that I'm going to be using to plan since they are officially chosen. I know I'm really indecisive and I change things up all the time. I don't know why that is. I'm just very fickle? I don't know. So a couple things I wanted to share with you guys. As promised in my last vlog, in my classroom setup vlog, my first one, I'm going to share with you guys our district's return to learn plan. So I'm going to be teaching in the district near Queen Creek. I don't want to say the exact name of the school district, but the Queen Creek area, I'm going to be teaching there. And they have created a return to learn plan. Parents will be given an option to send their children to school in person or send them to a virtual academy that is a complete different entity than the in-classroom option. So in-person would have teachers, me, other teachers, and then online would have their own set of teachers, their own set of curriculum. It's kind of its own entity. So parents are given the option whether to return in person or virtual. If they choose virtual, each student who needs a Chromebook will be given one. The district is going to give them a Chromebook if they choose to go online. Students who will work in person will also have their own assigned Chromebook in the classroom so they won't have to share with any other student. The school district purchased more devices so that every student can have a one-to-one device because we want to try to keep paper use to a minimum, just because that's just one more way to spread you know what. So the students who return to school will be coming to campus 5 days a week. There will be limited recess. There will be grab and go breakfast and lunch. Students will be doing recess with their own cohorts. So every class will have its own designated recess time so that cohorts of students can be kept together. There's going to be temperature checks, hand washing, you guys know, all of the things, but they are expecting students to come 5 days a week. If students want to switch online, they can, but they do have to finish out the quarter, I believe, where they are. I don't know exactly that detail. It said that they needed to finish the quarter, which to me sounds like they have to finish whatever quarter they're in the classroom, and then they can switch. I think it's all because of grading purposes, because they are moving from one institution to another. So we were supposed to begin teaching on July 22nd in my district, and we were going to be virtual for the first 2 days of school. It was going to be the 22nd and 23rd, and then the 27th students were going to come to campus. Since then, Governor Ducey has announced that he is going to postpone opening schools in person to August 17th, which is when most of Arizona schools begin. They usually begin like the first week of August. My district is a year-round district, so we have longer breaks in the middle, which I'm so excited about because I'd rather have a shorter summer and longer breaks. But as far as opening schools go, I don't really know yet. So I begin trainings next week, July 7th, and that whole rest of the week. And I'm assuming we're going to begin virtually so that we can keep our district calendar. So that means that we will be virtual from July 22nd to August 17th, pending everything goes well and we can actually go back to school. My fingers are crossed that we can actually go to school to work, like teachers can go to their classrooms to work, because I'm so unmotivated at home. I will do so much better if I'm in my own classroom, like my office. I can just do all my like science demonstrations there. I can do all my lessons there. I think it would be so much more productive if teachers could return to their classrooms and work from there. You know, obviously we have a little bit more discipline. We can stay away from each other. As long as we stay in our own classrooms, I feel like it would be no problemo. Fingers are crossed for that. Okay, I'm starting to ramble. So, as far as planning goes, I have sort of taken a standstill on planning like what I'm gonna teach and when, because I don't know if we're gonna go back virtually or if we're gonna just wait until August. So I do have like the first 4 weeks of like what standard I'm teaching and all my learning targets for those standards. And so I'm gonna just wait there because if I teach online, it's gonna look very different than if I teach in the classroom. So I'm kind of waiting for that. So I am gonna show you guys what I'm using to plan. So I might be switching from this view to a computer view or to an iPad view. So my iPad planner, I talked about this in my last video, one of my last videos, that I was shopping for a planner. I did announce this on Instagram, but I wanted to just share it with you guys here on YouTube so that you guys can be inspired. And if you like it, you can go and grab it. So I use GoodNotes on my iPad to plan. And the planner that I chose was the Boss Babe Planner, and I will link it down here below. What I like about it is that it has, and I'm gonna begin my screen recording here on my iPad. What I like about this planner is that it comes with pre-dated planning. So I can go without having to write every single date down in the corner of every box. And it just saves me a little bit of time. I can just swipe to the page that I want and then I'm done. It comes with a full month layout, which is what I'm showing you here on my iPad. And of course, you guys can see that I've already filled in some important days. It comes with a week at a glance. So if you want to just write basic things, have a week at a glance, you can do that. And then it also comes with a daily layout. So it is predated for every day, and in every day's area, you have a morning routine space, you have a top three, so those are like your priorities, you have a to-do list, you have a meal tracker and a workout tracker. You also then have a spot for your schedules and appointments, and then of course there's a wellness tracker down there too if you want to track your water intake or things like that. So every day of the week there is a daily layout, and then on the last day on the Friday there's a week of thoughts, so you can kind of reflect on your week, and then there's like a brain dump for the next week, and then again there's another week layout. This goes all the way into June 2021, and it's really cool. At the end of the planner, she also includes sticker pages and other really cool templates that you could use if you're a really rigorous planner. I am not, but these are, so this page that I'm showing you right here is a shortcut to the different templates. So there's personal planning, health and wellness, there are blank pages, there's life organization, cleaning checklist, home inventory, there's stickers, there's project planning, goal setting, and dream planning. So that's why I really like this planner. I really love the font. I really love the stickers that she made. They're more like doodle stickers that you can put in there. So this is gonna be where I plan all of my personal and professional dates. So if we have an assembly, which we probably won't have, if we have a staff meeting, if I have an IEP meeting, if there's any type of event that I need to write down or a due date that I have from as a professional, I will be writing all of this in this planner so that I can keep track of everything. I like to color code like personal plans in pink and then school plans in blue. That way I really can see what's going on. So that is the planner that I chose for my iPad. That is going to be my regular life planner. And then as far as lesson planning goes, I am going to use planbook.com. I love planbook.com because it has all of your standards already typed in, put in there. You just click and drag them into your lessons. You can type everything up, separated by block one, block two, block three, and then you can just print them. So if your principal is someone who likes you to submit your lesson plans, you can always share them through planbook.com, or you can always print them. It's really nice because they have an app on the iPad, so I can plan using my iPad if I'm just working from home. You can access it on your phone, your laptop, and then like let's say you're absent, you can email them to your teammates to print for your substitute. So I really like planbook.com. I'm gonna show you guys a short little video that shares Planbook's features. So let's do that right now. Okay, so here I am on the regular homepage of planbook.com. You can see that everything is able to be customized. So I've changed the colors of my blocks. And what I'll probably do is if certain things are scheduled for certain blocks, I will write them in my digital planner in the same color so that it all can coordinate. But basically, you are able to create different classes. And then within each class, you can change the plans up. So if you're gonna teach the same thing for all three blocks, if you're departmentalized like me, you can just copy and paste all of your plans down in there. But if you are doing something different for each block, let's say one block is more ahead than the others, you can of course change your plans. Within each block, you are able to click and drag in standards. Mine are labeled in the homework section right now. I need to change that, but normally this would be labeled standard. But you can literally click and drag certain standards that you're using into this planbook.com planning system. So let's say I'm using, now I have set mine to the Arizona state standards, and then I also have access to the next gen standards. So let's just say I'm gonna use this one. It will pull up all of my standards that I'm going to use. So we're going to just pretend we're using this one. We click check, and then it will automatically put your standards in for you. You can also, of course, write your learning targets. You can talk about what homework assignments the kids are going to do, and then you can type up the activity you're using. So instead of writing this with a pencil or a pen in a planner, you can just type it in, and then of course if you need to make changes, you can do that. You can also share, copy and paste lessons with your teammates. So if you guys are teaching all subjects and one of you wants to plan reading and one of you wants to plan math, you can just send the lessons that you've planned to your teammate, and they can just paste them right there in their plan book. So this is really cool. You can do start times, end times. You can obviously edit text, things like that. You can also attach things. So if you are sending a lesson plan to another teacher, you can attach the items that you're using and they have access right away. So that is why I love PlanBook. It's just right there at your fingertips. If you want to move a lesson, you just click it and shift it to the next day. It will ask you, of course, if you want to override it, and then you can move it. So if you don't get to something because something came up, you can just push it to the next day. And then of course you can print your plans in different formats, landscape, portrait, day by day, hour by hour, week by week. You can also see your month at a glance view on planbook.com as well. And that is really helpful for planning ahead of time. So that is why I love planbook.com, and I've used it for the last 4 years. So it's kind of something that I am used to. I thought about doing an Erin Condren planner or a happy planner, and I just couldn't bring myself to do it because PlanBook is so simple and I've been using it so long. So one more thing I wanted to talk with you guys about. This video is already 13 minutes long, but I think I'm doing pretty good. If I can keep it to under 20, I'm winning. Okay, so when I got to my classroom last week, you guys saw, if you watched it, I did discover that I do have a curriculum. It wasn't complete. I am missing one of the modules, I think. I'm missing module one, but I believe my district did purchase me, or my school at least, PhD Science, which is made by Great Minds. And I did have time to kind of zoom through it and see some of the lessons, and they are really cool. There isn't a ton of hands-on. It's mostly like observations and watching demonstrations, which is fine. So I'll probably use this as much as I possibly can and then throw in my own twists and turns in there. So I do have PhD Science. I have the first, I have modules 2, 3, and 4. And so I have student books, and then I also have teacher editions here. So I'm kind of looking through those, but again, I'm waiting to plan until I know where I'm teaching, if I'm gonna be teaching from here, from school, or at school. So, and then something else that I purchased over the summer was Science Fusion. So I didn't know if I was gonna have a curriculum coming in, and so I wanted to find something that I could use as kind of like a roadmap. And so I did purchase this textbook from Amazon. It's just a student textbook, so inside it's all student-led. Or student, I guess this is what the kids would have, not for the teacher. This is not the teacher edition. But I really like it. It's really cool. It has hands-on activities inside, labs, really colorful pictures, and it also has an online component, which I don't have, but it would probably be really easy to create lessons using this. So I just figured this is just one more thing that I can have if I need ideas, because I've never been able to actually teach science the way it should be taught. The last 6 years of my career, I've had 30 minutes or less to teach science and social studies. So I've never really been able to teach it correctly. It's always just kind of been, you know, informational text and then trying to get those standards met in like an ELA area with an extra 30 minutes. So I'm really excited to have 90 minutes a day. If we go in person, I'll have 90 minutes a day to teach science and social studies. So I'm planning on doing like a bi-weekly plan. So week A would be science, week B would be social studies. I've mentioned that before. And so hopefully that will be really helpful. Okay, so that is the end of this video. I know that it was really chatty and I pushed a lot of information at you guys. That's all I got for you today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you're not following me on Instagram, make sure you do so. I do post lots of updates there as well. And I will see you guys in the next one.